presenting this almost as a moral issue. Why is that? What are the spiritual dimensions of this?
Well, we're borrowing between 40 and 41 cents out of every dollar that we're spending at the federal level. And many Americans, and I would include myself among them, see that as generational theft. And theft, you know, there's a commandment against that in the Bible. We're literally stealing our children and our grandchildren's future.
There's also a commandment about charity and righteousness. In the Jewish tradition, the word is tzedakah, and it means not just charity, but it's an obligation of righteousness. And to take care of your neighbor, I understand the question of theft, but there's an equally powerful religious argument to be made of as a nation, mm-hmm, providing for the least among us, and that is equally powerful moral argument.
But not with money you steal from some other people from your future generation.
I think if you want to deal with theft, then we ought to talk about the rich paying their proper share of taxes.
And they're paying over 50% now.
Let me finish. I think that when we deal with the fact that those that raise the moral issue around generational theft, but at the same time want to give tax breaks to the wealthy and corporations, it would seem to me that our children would have to ask, who was really robbing us?
There are a couple of things here. One is that setting of priorities inside the budget, so that when you're talking about taking away money from our children, yes, everybody's concerned about the debt and the deficit. That's a given. But then you say, okay, what do we spend our money on? And that's where, when you, Catholics would call it a preferential option for the poor. So you have those concerns. But also, I think, Dr. Land, that there are other values other than standard of living, and that one of the things that we also do want to pass on to our children is a sense of this country all being in it together, mm-hmm, and that's been the great American tradition, and they're not the haves and have-nots, you know, and I think that that is something that we also
Let me turn to Ibu on that note, you know, a country for everybody.
Right.
You are a Muslim, you, mm-hmm, have been on President Obama's Interfaith Faith Reach Out panel. Many of the Catholics in this country had set a standard for charity in the early days, and I know the Muslim community looks at it as well. What sort of examples do you think your community is trying to get for themselves in this regard?
Well, my son goes to Catholic school, and this being Easter week, we're talking a lot about Jesus. And Muslims have a different theological view of Jesus than Christians do. But what we share with Christians is the idea of Jesus as a messenger of mercy, as an exemplar of mercy. And the Good Samaritan story is a perfect example of this, that the good neighbor, the one who achieves eternal life in the story, is the one who is a mercy.